गवर्नर ऑफ तमिलनाडु श्री बनवारी लाल पुरोहित जी, प्रेसिडेंट इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ इंजीनियर्स इंडिया श्री शिशिर कुमार बनर्जी, हु हैज टेकन ओवर टुडे विद द सपोर्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू, मिनिस्टर फॉर रेवेन्यू एंड डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट श्री उदय कुमार जी, other distinguished on the dais, ladies and gentlemen, this is my first visit to Tamil Nadu since being elected as the President of India. And it is appropriate that it has coincided with the valedictory function of the 32nd Indian Engineering Congress organized by the Institution of Engineers. This is a land of engineers as well as social engineers who have contributed a lot to our country. As such, I am glad to be here in Chennai. The discipline of engineering combines the excitement of science and technology with the rigor of structure. These attributes are intrinsic to Tamil society. If we go into the impressive history of the Tamil people, we encounter Chola, naval, and trading ships that were traveling up and down the Indian Ocean 1,000 years ago. Even older is the complex of shore monuments in Mamallapuram, built by another great Tamil dynasty, the Pallavas. The landscaping and the intricate drainage system of Mamallapuram are fascinating even to this day. All these are samples of a very advanced level of engineering. Earlier in the morning, I was honored to visit Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Memorial in Rameswaram, along with the late Sri R. Venkat Raman. Dr. Kalam is one of two former presidents, my illustrious predecessors, to have come from Tamil Nadu. Dr. Kalam trained as an engineer and became famous as a missile technologist. More than that, he was a proud son of India. Dr. Kalam could have earned millions in the West, but he chose to devote his learning and his life to the development of our country. All of us as Indians and all of you as engineers must draw inspiration from him. A spirit of inquiry and of evidence-based policy and an abiding faith in technology and innovation as tools for the welfare of the people has been a hallmark of public life in modern Tamil Nadu. Right from the days of Rajaji and Periyar, the state has made impressive strides in social reform. Our green revolution and self-sufficiency in food owes so much to stalwarts from Tamil Nadu, such as the late Sri C. Subramanian and the distinguished scientist Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. The journey of reform and of people's welfare continued under Sri Annadurai and Sri K. Kamraj. Sri M.G. Ramchandran, whose birth centenary we are celebrating this year, and Dr. J. Jayalalitha took Tamil Nadu even further. And I cannot forget to mention that gifted wordsmith and patriarch of our politics, Sri M. Karunanidhi. These distinguished political and social leaders, and I have mentioned only a few, have given Tamil Nadu a rich legacy. The midday meal scheme that originated in Tamil Nadu gave India a model to combat malnutrition and help in the physical and cognitive development of our children. And whether it is in textiles or IT, precision manufacture or automobiles, Tamil Nadu has used engineering to build a solid industrial economy, creating thousands of jobs. Ladies and gentlemen, the institution of engineers is close to 100 years old. It was founded in 1920 as an institution that would advance the cause of engineering and technology in India. It set the benchmark. Prior to the formation of the All India Council of Technical Education in 1987, the institution of engineers used to regulate engineering and technical education in the country. The institution of engineers has also played a crucial role in promoting a culture of R&D. It has encouraged and sponsored even undergraduate engineering students to push the frontiers of their curriculum and of innovation. This has led to the Ministry of Science and Technology conferring the status of a scientific and industrial research organization on the institution of engineers. Engineers are agents of change. Historically, it is engineers who have used the logic of science to achieve practical solutions, whether building dams or bridges, whether designing locomotives or computers. From the earliest metal tools to the integrated circuit, from the 18th century industrial revolution to the 21st century fourth industrial revolution, it is engineering that has spoken the language of the future. Today, in exploring the possibilities of artificial intelligence and the Internet of Things, or in realizing our aspirations for Make in India, once more it is to our engineers that we turn. These opportunities are all the more important because human civilization is at an inflection point. The evolution of technology is changing how we live, work, and think. It is also challenging the practice of engineering. Traditional fields of engineering will continue to thrive. After all, we will still need machines, tools, and power grids, roads and bridges, aircraft and ships. But this traditional practice of engineering will have to both embrace and drive innovation in cutting-edge areas. For example, civil engineers are specialists in materials. They use this knowledge for construction. Yet, this same knowledge of composites and materials will increasingly be deployed for both micro needs, such as creating medical implants for the human body, as well as macro needs. For instance, constructing facilities and maybe even colonies in outer space. Developments across different fields are creating avenues for cross-fertilization. Disciplines such as food technology, biotechnology, environmental engineering, and transportation engineering are expanding the horizons of engineers. And engineers will inevitably intersect with disciplines as far apart as law, geography, and political science. Engineers can play a much larger role in solving key challenges facing our country in food, healthcare, and the environment, in providing low cost and easy to build housing, and in enhancing urban infrastructure with minimum disruption. The responsibility that all this places upon you is enormous. Engineers are being called upon to be nation builders in more ways than we can imagine. Again, this is not without precedent. The late M. Visveswaraya was an administrator, irrigation specialist, and town planner of repute. He trained as an engineer and his birthday is commemorated as Engineers Day. Dr. Satish Dhawan, who pioneered India's space program and made it relevant to our farmers, was an engineer. India's much-loved milkman, Varghese Kurien, who led the White Revolution, was an engineer. And the metroman, E. Sridharan, who built the Konkan Railway and the Delhi Metro in extremely difficult circumstances, also studied engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, these are just a few examples of engineers who rose beyond the call of their everyday work and contributed to our national life. Their stories tell us what engineers can achieve. May the adventure and the achievement never cease. With those words, I wish all of you the very best for the future. Thank you. Jai.